Welcome back to Reading Bear. Today, we'll take a look at some new MID a-hole stories. And if you enjoyed my content, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and post some bear emojis in the comments. Let's go!
First one posted by user, Aita Phones at Work. Titled, Aita for deliberately running up mileage on a company car? I have been working for Barry for 4 years. When I first came to work as his apprentice, I was the only person he employed. He now has a construction company with 19 employees. Recently, after having repeated issues with new young hires, he introduced a no phones on the work site policy. I assumed this didn't apply to me as it seemed to be in relation to a couple of incidents with new hires. Also, as site manager, I needed my phone on me to contact Barry if there was a problem on site, as he would usually be at his house drafting plans or in meetings while the rest of us were on the work sites that were between 10 to 40 minutes drive away, and outside of driving there was no other way to contact him. About a week after the policy came in, I called him in relation to an issue we had found: water main in a different place to where the plans showed and right where we were supposed to be driving piles, and he basically tore a strip off me in front of everyone. That was 4 weeks ago and I haven't had my phone on me whilst on the clock since. Instead, I drive the company car to his house every time there's a problem. Obviously, this makes projects go much slower and has been chewing through more gas than usual, but he didn't notice until this week when he was checking last month's books and noticed that the average gas consumption had almost doubled and several jobs that would have normally been completed hadn't. He called me beside himself and I pointed out that I had no other option as he didn't want me using my phone. He told me to use common sense and I said that I had been and I'd gotten a new a-hole torn for it. He hung up and hasn't mentioned it, but after discussing it with my wife, I'm starting to feel guilty. Did I go too far? User comment, not the a-hole. This is perfect. You did exactly what Barry wanted of you. You tried to use your phone for your job, in the interest of keeping a smooth operation, which gets Barry money. Well, if Barry saw this as a violation of this rule, and tried to use you as an example by chewing you out in front of everyone, he got exactly what he asked for and should have expected. How else was he expecting to get information on issues he was getting via phone prior to the new no phone policy? Unless he provides another means of communication, like a dedicated work phone or carrier pigeon, Barry can keep paying for his pride. User comment, in this case, malicious compliance is all you can do. Tearing into you for doing your job in front of your co-workers is unprofessional, so he can eat the costs of you doing exactly what he wanted. Not the a-hole at all. User comment, not the a-hole. It sounds like he didn't think through his policy and is now being an a-hole to you because it's costing him money. You had no reason to believe that calling him again, after he chewed you out for that exact thing, would be well received. Referring to that as common sense is absurd. Next one posted by user, Father of Boys 1995. Titled, Aita for taking my car back? Back in October of last year, I was upgraded to a company car through my work. This left us with an extra car we had to make a payment on sitting in the driveway. I have a cousin. We will call him DD, has had a lot of problems with his life. He's been in and out of prison, and after his mum died, he fell hard into controlled substances. Word travels fast in my family and everyone knew I had an extra car. Well, D called me up and asked me if he could use it. I talked with my wife and we decided if we make the insurance payment and keep it registered, all he has to do is make the car payment $165 bi-weekly. He had a job, so I decided I would do that. It's been 3 months since we gave him the car. Almost four. I thought it would be smooth, but I have had to chase him and go knock on his door for every payment. He always paid it, but he wouldn't just come do it. It got very frustrating. 2 days ago, he was arrested in my car. He had illegal stuff on him and was taken to jail. All the while, my car was ransacked by the police. Vents ripped out, inserts ripped out, just destroyed the interior. Upon further investigation, I noticed that over 30,000 miles have been put on the car in just short of 4 months. Infuriated at this point, I told my mum and other members of my family he wouldn't be getting the car back. I said this to them because he called me from jail and asked if I'd park it at his house. I said, absolutely not, I'm taking it back and selling it. He hangs up and then I begin getting berated by family for screwing him out of a car. Calling me in a hole. But the car was in perfect condition before it went to him. Like detailed, clean, low miles. Looked like a rental. And now I have had it quoted and will probably lose my butt on it. I did him a favor and I got boned and now I just need to understand how and if I'm truly in a hole. I feel I did my due diligence. User comment, not the a-hole. The guy betrayed your trust whilst you were just trying to give him a favor. It's your car so you should be able to take it back anyway, but he's clearly abusing that trust so you have the complete right to take it back. User comment, not the a-hole. You ducked up by lending the car to a known addict with known trouble with the law. The car is in your name and you could face future issues if he continues to use it. What if he does something illegal and then tries pinning it on you? Cut and run. User comment, feel like it's obvious but, not the a-hole. You still own it, he was renting it, and his actions practically destroyed the car. Only other real option is to offer him to buy it outright, for whatever it might have been worth before all that damage. He ducked you over, dude, no clue what your family is thinking. Next one posted by user, Aita 3099713. Titled, Aita for refusing to help my stepbrother pay for his wife's surgery using my inheritance money? First of all, I male 39 just wanna say duck cancer. I've lost my mum and my son to this awful disease. My son passed away in 2015. Every day it still hurts the same. My mum and dad were divorced. I mostly lived with my dad for several reasons. My stepbrother and I don't get along so well. To be frank, I do not see him as a brother because of how he behaved during my mum's and my son's difficult days. I took care of my mother solely. My dad didn't care. He didn't even try to get the family to comfort me by at least visiting once in a while, during my mum's sickness and after her death. No one wanted to spend time with me and I was not invited to birthdays, family dinners, night, etc. This year's Christmas was filled with tears and unpleasant memories. My loved ones weren't there, I was literally wallowing in my misery. Reminiscing about how my life used to be before everything was ruined. I remember 1 week after my son's death. My stepbrother had his wedding. He actually had the nerve to send me an invitation via my dad, thinking that I might attend. I was upset. They downplayed my grief and made it worse to process my loss. I inherited money from my mum. I haven't done anything with it yet. I decided to not make major decisions during the first year of grief. My days are the same, I just visit my aunt from time to time and we talk. My dad and stepmom have been visiting my stepbrother's wife who was in, out of the hospital for the past 2 months. I honestly don't ask since my stepmom and her son don't feel comfortable talking about it. My dad sat with me and talked about the family putting money together to help pay for medical debts and prepare for my stepbrother's wife's surgery at the end of February. He asked since I now have money then I can contribute and help with the surgery. I refused and tried to change the subject. But he went on arguing about how I'm supposed to help my brother and support him especially now. I only replied by asking him one question. I asked him, where was my brother when I was struggling? My dad didn't like that, he told me to let bygones be bygones and stop making this about me and making the situation hard for everyone. He said he promised my stepmom and stepbrother that he'll convince me to pay and I'm making him look bad right now. We ended up yelling at each other. I told him that's not my problem. He got my aunt involved in this mess and keeps saying I'm giving up on family and I'm being spiteful and bitter. I felt guilty but felt awful that they're asking for my mum's money. My mum who they didn't even visit while she was sick. I understand what they're going through because I lived it with my son. It's every father's worst nightmare to see their son struggle like that. Then to have to suffer another great loss is too much. User comment, not the a-hole. Your dad certainly is though for telling his family that he would convince you to pay. Duck him. You are not obligated to take care of anyone but yourself. If you want to help that's great, but it seems they just want to use you. Do whatever makes you feel best. User comment, not the a-hole. Don't let them guilt trip you. You can bet that after giving them your mum's money, they would start treating you the same way they did. I am so sorry for the loss of your mother and your son, op, and you deserve better than your father's family. User comment, not the a-hole. Their family when it suits them to hold their hands out for your money. If your father is afraid of looking bad because he made a promise that he has no right to make, that's on him. If your mum was here, do you think she'd want you to hand over her money to these people? I'd lay odds that she left it to you so you could use it to make your life more comfortable and that this is what she would want you to do with her legacy. Next one posted by user, One Lost Slav. Titled, WIBTA if I sued my boyfriend's elderly mother and pressed charges against her. Okay, I know how this sounds. Please hear me out at least. I've been with my boyfriend for 11 years, since I was 15. His mother has hated me since the first day she met me. She hated me due to my ethnicity, Kosovan Albanian, she hated me due to my career. I work as a model and she decided that makes me an empty-headed, vain, shallow person. Then when I told her I still planned to go to university alongside my career, she said I was doing it to impress my boyfriend. I've since left uni with a distinction and her new reason to hate me is I try too hard. She has also insisted I've cheated on him throughout our entire relationship, which is a ridiculous claim. I've never even kissed another man in my whole life. I have zero desire to cheat and never will. Late last year she attempted to void the insurance on my boyfriend's motorbikes. She tried to do this under my name so, hypothetically, when he was arrested for riding with no insurance and called his insurance company, I'd get the blame. After this happened my boyfriend and I agreed to cut her out, however it hasn't stuck, she left my boyfriend alone and respected his wishes for NC but she's continued to contact and harass me. This leads to the last few weeks, my boyfriend works as a motorcycle test rider and he got in an awful motorbike crash while working, as such I now need to care for him. I'm okay with that and I'm focusing on seeing it as an opportunity for us to get closer, it's been nice honestly. However his mother has been awful to me. She's called me litany of terms. From things as tame as stupid to things as awful as a nasty Serbian half-breed. I'm not Serbian and she's well aware that calling a Kosovan a Serb is offensive. I tried to block her so she started making new iMessage accounts and began to continuously harass me via those accounts. Then came Friday night. The police turned up at our door. I was pretty confused and was quickly told they were there to do a welfare check as they'd received multiple claims of horrific abuse I was apparently putting my poor boyfriend under. Obviously they quickly discovered he was fine, albeit grumpy and they left. I know for a fact it was his mother, some of the details the police mentioned made that obvious. I'm now at a point where I've realized I literally cannot do this. I'm going to press charges against her for the insurance and harassment, it's a crime in the UK, and I'm likely going to sue her for damages. For the sake of my mental health I need to do this. I don't want to be a victim and she needs to be forced to stop. I have mentioned my intentions to her if she doesn't back off and she's pretty much mocking me and saying I won't. I absolutely will. I just feel like this morally may make me an awful person. She sucks, I know this, however she's old and miserable enough as is and I feel like doing this may ruin whatever small amount of life she has left. It feels like it may be too far. I really don't know though and I genuinely cannot be objective here. WIBTA here if I did this? Edit, when I say I need to care for my boyfriend, I mean he's essentially immobile, he's not being unsupportive. He's just barely able to take care of himself, let alone battle his mother too. User comment, keep your current numbers and get new ones. Give the new numbers to everyone you wish except for her. By keeping the old number, she still sees this as the route to contact you. If the original numbers are inactive though, she'll be tipped off. Also, by keeping the old numbers, this allows you to save evidence of her harassment. Similar steps can be taken with other forms of contact like email. You don't want to have contact with her. Don't. Negative responses are still responses. Sending a text saying, I don't want to talk to you, is talking to them. As hard as it may be, simply end all communication. This being said, a restraining order and/or lawsuit may actually not help, but upset her more and create greater emotional investment on her part. Also, the lawsuit may create additional emotional strain for you by it demanding your attention as it drags on. Again, the goal if the goal is no contact and reducing your mental stress, then do just that. Read The Gift of Fear by Gavin De Becker, which discusses predicting violent behavior and what leads up to it, including various types of harassment and how to handle it. Also, not the a-hole. User comment, not the a-hole, she sounds awful and extremely toxic. You said you keep blocking her number, but it may just be easier to change your own phone number so she can't keep reaching you. It sucks because I know people get attached to their number, but that may help. Hope things get better. User comment, I'd seriously advise that you think of the impact of this on your relationship, solely because you mentioned whatever small amount of life she has left. Don't get me wrong, I'm 100% on board with suing her. Just lay it out for your partner so he doesn't go blaming you if something does happen, or when the case goes through. And by the way, totally not the a-hole. Enough is enough. Next one posted by user, Aita Borrowing. Titled, Aita for refusing to let neighbor borrow my husband for her lie. My husband, 42 male, and I, 31 male, live in a nice apartment. We aren't really friends with our neighbors, we're polite but that's about it. Our upstairs neighbor Kelly is a lesbian, closet. She only told us because she assumes all LGBT plus needs to be friends, who's never told her family. Well, she's been lying to her mother about having a boyfriend, by describing my husband, red-haired, groomed beard, former Marine. She came to our apartment to ask a huge favor. Her mother was coming over to dinner. She needed my husband to act like her boyfriend and break up with her. I asked if she was serious, but told Kenny it's up to him. Kenny held up his hand to show his wedding ring and said only way it's coming off if someone chops the finger off and no way is he going to act as her fill-in boyfriend or a cheating husband. Kelly begged us to reconsider, but I told her no means no. She brought up that gays need to stick together, but I hold firm, Kenny is my man. And he said no too. Kelly has since told her mum about being a lesbian and that made her mum leave without staying for dinner, Kelly told us. Kelly says we're both vicious a-holes for forcing her to come out and we say we aren't because she lied about a man. Aita? User comment, not the a-hole, lies have consequences. It totally sucks that her mother hurt her and that she felt she need to hide who she is, but she can't demand people come rescue her from her own lies. That boy's a keeper though, I can see the appeal. User comment, not the a-hole. Even without you helping her, she didn't have to come clean to her mother. Not hard to just say, sorry, me and Mr. Marine broke up. I mean, you could have helped her, honestly something you would have laughed about and the ring thing is a bit weird but none of that makes you the a-hole for not helping. She is misplacing her blame, but don't be too tough on her, she's obviously going through a lot. User comment, not the a-hole. She lied, she faces the consequences. You're never an a-hole for refusing to bail someone out of their own mess. She's a huge a-hole for trying to get you involved in her lie. She's also a huge a-hole for trying to pull in group identity. No. She made individual decisions. It's not the responsibility of the group to bail her out. Maybe she should have asked for permission before using your husband's description as a fake boyfriend. Last one posted by user, sorry for what did. Titled, Aita for getting a male coworker fired after he made an inappropriate joke about me? So I'll try to make this short. I am the youngest in our workplace and I get along with a few coworkers older than me. I'm 22 female and they are plus 30 females. One day I decided to play some Arab music and dance for one of my coworkers in a joking way. It was fun actually. I was like dancing very close to her and like hugging her and all that stuff. We were only women in the room. Then a male coworker got in and I stopped but he saw what I was doing. He made a comment about me being the stripper of the place. I got mad and told him to apologize as I think it was offensive. He didn't. So I went to our boss and told him what he said. My coworkers encouraged me. He got fired. We have a public job and it's very difficult getting fired. But this comment falls under the sexual harassment category. I didn't report him for sexual harassment, I just told him what he said. I didn't expect these consequences. And now I feel bad but not really because he should know to not make this type of comments. Edit, what I did wasn't inappropriate. What I think I did wrong was talking to his boss instead of talking to him or ignoring him and waiting until he made another comment and then formally reporting him. I work in a police station doing paperwork, not as a police officer. The cops working here always play music in the lunchroom. If they are cheerful, they even sing along with it. I decided to play my culture music and danced with a co-worker and messed around with her. It's my fault that some people think Arab music and dance is inappropriate? I know I didn't describe it at first. But people here have very long shifts. They look for ways to make time go faster. I had nothing to do and I went to hang out with them and change the music. Instead of Western music, I had Arab music playing and I started dancing with her. Everyone was cheering because they had been listening to music during their break and messing around. Why didn't explain this? Because it doesn't matter. I was asking if I was in the bad for talking to my boss instead of solving things in a different way. And I don't know why everyone assumes I was being sexual. I wasn't. As a North African woman, I can tell it's not always something sexual. Women back in my country dance around with other female family, friends. Even kids dance to Arab music and belly dance. Second edit, why are you all so angry? Some people have been taking it personally and have been assuming a lot of stuff I didn't say and it's just a lie. I'm done reading all these comments based on assumptions and things I didn't say honestly. How is everyone so fixated that I was harassing someone? It's a police station. We have security cameras everywhere. Keep that in mind. And by the way, I'm not homophobic for saying that me dancing with a woman is not the same as me dancing with a man. I'm not even going to debate about it. User comment, not the a-hole. Everyone here is acting like they're the picture of unsmiling professionalism at all times. Like they've never been a little cheeky with their work bestie when no one else is around. The male coworker who was not a part of the conversation decided to make a sexual comment. One doesn't get fired for one instance of vulgar speech, so it's likely he's done this before. User comment, everyone sucks here. Your place of employment is not a dance club. What he said was inappropriate, but what you did was also inappropriate. It doesn't matter who was enjoying it. Frankly, if I was the coworker you were dancing close to and hugging, that would have made me very uncomfortable. Your company probably has very strict rules about harassment. He got himself fired, but you were not innocent party in this. User comment, not the a-hole. Because the thing is, it's hard to get fired there. That means they needed a full scope of the situation. They likely asked others who were present that occurred. That means you likely weren't dancing provocatively, just clowning around. Thanks for listening.